We're here at the installer show at the NEC checking out all the great products and ideas that are attempting to pave the way to a greener future. And if there's a sign that plumbers and electricians are going to have to work more closely together than ever before, then this is the place to prove it. But the trend is definitely towards electrification, and to that end, we're going to answer the question, what is a prosumer? Now, this question stems from the brand new section of BS 7671, namely Part 8, which has the rather odd title of Functional Requirements and currently provides information in Chapter 82 about prosumers, low voltage electrical installations. But just what does that word prosumer mean? The first time we used it in a video, we got a lot of comments from marketing people who told us that prosumer means professional consumer or professionally featured consumer products. However, in the wiring regs, it means something else. From the birth of commercial electricity, it's been pretty much standard practice for electricity to be generated somewhere remotely from a property and then to ship it in via the supply network. However, with the rise of renewables, there's been an increasing trend for property owners to start generating their own electricity. It seemed to start out as a niche activity that you may have spotted on shows like Grand Designs and was reserved for the ultra wealthy or the off-grid eco warrior. Now, however, with the cost of energy spiraling and the reduction of reliance on fossil fuels, we're seeing a massive increase in the use of renewable energy technology on individual properties from commercial buildings to homes, mostly in the form of photovoltaic panels, sometimes from other sources like small wind turbines. And this is what's given rise to the inclusion of that word prosumer in BS 7671. It's simply a portmanteau, or joining of two words together, of producer and consumer. So a prosumer, according to the wiring regs, is someone who both produces and consumes their own electricity. The development of this area has led to expectations of serious growth in the coming years as more and more people adopt the technology. So it's worth a quick overview of how a system could work, because with the rise of EVs, it's fair to say that the electrical grid is going to be put under a fair bit of strain in the future, and the prosumer is going to play a pretty big part in easing that, as their power production will help to contribute to the pool of available electricity. There's a really neat illustration in the regs of how a prosumer's electrical installation, or as it's snappily abbreviated in the regs, PEI, could look. So let's take a look at that. The idea of a prosumer is not to disconnect completely from the grid, as there may always be a need to import a little bit, and if you have an excess, you can actually sell it back to the grid, although there are more cost-effective ways of dealing with the extra, as we'll see in a moment. So we'll have a connection to the public network, as shown here by the transformer symbol. And along the top next to the public network, we've got the different ways that electricity could be generated at home. PV panels connected by a solar inverter, wind turbines connected via a wind inverter, and finally, some means of local generation. Although if someone does have all this installed, it may be worth checking to see if they're preparing for nuclear fallout as well. Notice the direction of the arrows here. You've got current flowing from these sources into the system. Then along the bottom, you've got typical electrical loads, home appliance and electronic devices, motors, lighting and heating. And you'll notice again, the arrows or direction of current are pointing towards the loads. Then on the end here, you've got possibly the heaviest load that a property will experience in the future, the electric vehicle. But notice that you've got a kind of diamond for the direction of current flow here. So what's that all about? Well, the answer lies in the symbol directly above, which is a battery. Makes sense to have some kind of on-site electrical storage because for many people, they drive their car, possibly an EV, to work, and our houses sit empty and not using much electricity all day, exactly at the time our PVs are producing the most electricity. So if we don't have battery storage, our lovely free electricity will likely start getting sold back to the grid at a fairly paltry rate, only for us to buy it back at an inflated rate when we get home and start showering, cooking, and using our electronic devices. So it makes way more sense to have a massive battery to charge up with all that lovely free electricity all day, and then start using it in the late afternoon and evening when we need it. But maybe at that point, the sun's starting to go down. So that little diamond below the battery and inverter actually indicates that the current can flow into the battery when it's charging and out when you're using it to cook dinner. So that little diamond above the EV also indicates that current is flowing in both directions. So your car, when it's plugged in, may well end up being used to supply current back into the house or even the supply network at times of high demand to ease pressure on the power stations. And just in case you're wondering, that little cloud at the right of the drawing doesn't represent the great confusion descending on us electricians trying to figure it all out. It's the EEMS, or Electrical Energy Management System. It might be better represented by a brain, as that's the bit that monitors and manages all of these disparate bits of kit and makes sure that the kettle will boil when we turn it on. So that's what a prosumer is and how it's going to affect our electrical installations. It may be a bit of a daunting time for electricians and users of electricity, but it's also a time of great opportunity. So keep yourself up to date with everything that's changing and going on in this dynamic and fast-paced industry by checking out events like the Installer Show, and also by checking out our videos like these ones here. Thank you very much for watching.